New dash cam video tonight, and I told you so moment from inside a cop car the night 11 people died in the I-75 pileup last January.
Yeah, the video and what we're hearing from the trooper talking to a deputy seems to confirm that not everyone felt the interstate should have been open.
Now, West 2's Dave McDaniel joins us here in the studio with dash cam video that really drives this point home.
Well, we knew in the FDLE report that came out last Thursday that there was documented disagreement between the FHP sergeant and his lieutenant that night. I-75 had been closed because of a crash around midnight. Smoke and fog in the area was an issue. Around 3:30, I-75 was reopened, and the fatal crashes occurred within a half hour. This video just released lets us hear a trooper vent about the decision to reopen the interstate.
No, you don't want to get to it. They have an explosion.
Sergeant Bruce Simmons of the State Patrol first tells an Alachua County Sheriff's deputy it's not safe ahead because of the immediate danger. Then he gives his version of, I told them so.
I tried to tell them to leave it some butt closed, and they wouldn't listen to me.
He says even though conditions had improved after a midnight crash caused by smoke and fog, he clearly was not comfortable that with the time of year and with the nearby brush fire, that there wasn't a great chance for a relapse.
I said, it's going to roll in again. Leave it closed.
Even the FDLE, while critical of the decision to open the interstate, saying the decision was based on incomplete information and not enough monitoring, admitted the conditions were clear at 3 in the morning.
I think at the time the road was reopened, the facts show that it was generally clear at that time. But there was information out there that could have been helpful to them, which would indicate those conditions could reoccur.
The FDLE says there were other things. Forestry reporting earlier that the lingering fire was smoky and the fact the road had been socked in just minutes before. All things that had this trooper sergeant sounding off.
Well, I said, I'm grabbing some breakfast, and I told the trooper, I said, 30, 45 minutes, you watch.
Turns out the road did get socked in. Violent crashes did happen.
Last week, a spokesperson in Tallahassee for the State Patrol said it was early to play the blame game, that it would implement changes based on the report, something the FDLE said it did not do well enough after a smoke and fog caused crash on I-4 in 2008.